Have you ever seen the Harry Potter movie where it looks like it's fucking rubber? It feels like it's rubber.
I've never seen Harry Potter.
That's the perfect. When you wake up, and your hands like that's the perfect time to jerk off. Yeah. Like,
go ahead and stroke that.
No.
Oh shit.
What'd you say before that? You did something. You said you did something, and I was gonna piggyback off of that.
How about the
about rubbing it off or something?
No, but when you said sleep paralysis, when you fall asleep.
Oh yeah, we're talking about sleep paralysis.
Like that little little bits of sleep when you before you're going to sleep, and you have them little mini dreams.
Yeah, and that's crazy because like you're not even in REM sleep yet. You don't get REM sleep until like 3-4 hours in. Like the best
deep sleep.
But like as far
do you know the percentage that you need?
What
of deep sleep? Yeah,
it's honestly, it's kind of minuscule for the most part.
Yeah, I don't know either. But
it's something that's like minuscule. That's why they'll say like for adults, you only need like 4 to 5 hours, and that's only because like you do so much during the day when you fucking go to sleep, you fall asleep, and then like you're starting right into REM sleep damn near.
Mm.
Because like you're so tired to where like your body's like I need to shut the fuck down. But like but to go back to the paralysis thing, like. Honestly, there is something that is that it means something, you know, as far as because I used to get that a lot. Like I used to always wake up and feel like I can't move, like I'm just like into the point to where like if I'm like having my head on the pillow and my nose is covered, I feel like I'm being smothered too, and I can't move, and like I used to freak me the fuck out. Like I swear to God, like I wake up and like when I finally was able to move, like I'm just like, man, I don't want to fucking go back to sleep. Like,
do you guys use bed sheets? Like bed sheet? Do you have like bed sheets, or do you just use a comforter?
Yeah, use bed sheets.
It depends. Yeah, it depends.
I think it's more comfortable.
Yeah. I'm just not a big fan of bed sheets, man. They kind of creep me out, you know.
Now see,
just like say somebody's breaking in, you know.
Bed sheets.
Bed sheets.
So what is
like
a bed sheet?
Like the there's a fitted sheet and then there's the bed sheet.
Yeah,
it's like fucking
the one like so you that got, goes you got the goes fitted, and then the bed or the,
yeah that's
the
what I just
and then the comforter and usually yeah like, so what's yeah. wrong with a bed sheet where you get like tangled up in it
yeah it's just fucked up man
so someone's breaking in and you
and
can't,
then yeah
like,
then
well, what's the difference between a bed sheet and a comforter if someone's breaking in
well a comforter I feel like a bed sheet just like fucking like holds you down, man.
You can kind of get caught in bed.
Yeah,
that's
why
I
hate hotels.
Like,
I hate hotels because
like
yeah.
If you're like twisting up in it,
but I mean, if you're
but like
you're
when you're sleeping, you're probably
twisting
like twisting. It. Yeah. So I'm saying like, boom, somebody breaks in. What the fuck? Like you're all twisted up, bro. You
yeah, lift the
assed out, man. Assed out. Yeah.
It was so, kind of to go off of what you're talking about hotels. It was kind of like just. Funny, like as you get older and you dive into adult videos, and most of them are filmed in said hotels across the country and world.
Are they?
Well, yeah, probably. Or which, I mean, like,
is that facts? Or?
I'm about to say which one he's looking at.
Well, I mean, I'm saying like unless you're like looking at like a luxury house or whatever.
That's what they do them at mostly. They just rent out houses.
But a lot of them do.
Is that
it.
Facts?
A lot of them do.
That's
them
facts.
At,
that's
do
facts.
Them at hotels. Mm-hmm. Like if you look.
Is that
at,
facts?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah. But I mean, okay, so.
But
I think I know what you're talking about.
But yeah,
because a lot of those people are like the underground people, like the Habib show. Do you know what the Habib show is? Mm-hmm. Like the Habib show is basically like one of those dudes that is. Trying to come up in porn, and then he has like
his,
different
like,
girls
his
and
like his
yeah
two,
different
yeah.
girls and shit like that, and you actually just take him to a hotel.
Mm-hmm. But it was just funny though because like my trip down to North Carolina for my family's wedding, we stayed at a $60 hotel one night on the way down, and my God, it was just
wait, why'd you got? It's like 8 hours. Why'd
not,
you?
Not, well, we
why'd you stop?
We left at 4 o'clock because
like working and shit over there.
Family surgery.
Oh damn. I was like, man, that's
yeah.
We'd make that drive and
yeah,
I would still make the drive.
No,
I was curious.
It was 9 hours, but we just went halfway for the night. But ooh. Anyway, so we stayed at the $60 hotel.
24 or with hotel. 4 hours of sleep.
Anyway, we stayed at the $60 hotel. And it was just funny, like, walking into it. Like, the day after, I was like, Mom, I got it. I'm sorry, Mom, Dad. I gotta say this, but I was like, I wonder how many pornos have been shot here. It was it was just like this kind of dungeon.
Oh, you said that to mom and dad?
Yeah,
that's funny.
Yeah, they're like, oh my god.
I'm actually, I would actually prefer to go to those hotels than the regular hotels, because there's more done at the more expensive hotels than it is done a lot of times at the motels. And then the motels are usually the ones where they're just doing drugs and shit like that.
That's true.
They're not, like, yeah, they may have some sex, but I feel like the more higher-end ones. Like, I don't think I told you, I didn't know this, but there's a guy that's standing in this room on, like, the first level at our hotel, but in, like, the West Wing. And so, like, I'm delivering food. No, I was actually doing, like, a tray run. So we basically got to go and all the halls and pick up dishes and shit like that if people have them. So I'm going down the on the first level, and then like I'm just walking through and I picked up this plate and I'm just keep going and all I hear is I was like literally like it was like I walked backwards like and then like I walked past again and I hear it again and I was like, what the fuck, you there tearing this shit up. So I walk from where that is to like the restaurant, and then I go back and I'm just like, man, I heard you just banging it out. So it's just like, and then like I'll go walk out and then dude's walking old girl out. Like,
and you see,
I was like, I see y'all shit yelling old Chinese ass, a little small cell. When I get my back broken.
Hey, man.
And it happened, and that's what I'm saying. It happens a lot because we have this other, like, we literally had this other group where this older man that had these women come from out of town to come to our hotel and stay with us and shit like that. I go to take a fucking amenity to his room, and literally, like, open up the door. There's two suitcases full of fucking high heel shoes.
Oh, I was just
you
were
so
say,
you
like,
can already tell
sex
that.
Toys.
No. You can already tell that they were, you know, probably
bringing in some ladies.
In, yeah. No, just to change in different shoes or what have you for the event. Yeah. Because that's one thing where it's like, okay, if this guy's wanting this, and then I'm like.
No, it is interesting, though, like with your experience working in like the hospitality industry, like just how I'm sure, yeah, like that shit is just a normal, like just people going in there to, you know, swingers or whatever it might be nowadays, sex parties or porn, you know, whatever it might be. And it's just crazy like how much it happens in different hotels and motels.
Yeah, I mean, it's one thing where I think it happens more than we pay attention to.
Mm-hmm.
Because like unless
I mean it's an industry.
Unless you're actually hip to it,
you don't think about it.
Mm-hmm.
You're like, you know, all right, I'm just going to go stay there. Like most people are like, all right, I'm going to go stay there, get breakfast, maybe kick it by the pool. Mm-hmm. But then you've got the complete other end of the spectrum where, yeah, you're, you know, pretty
much. Yeah, you're doing that or, you know, everybody has their own business on why they go to hotels or even.
Because they're cheap.
Or just even stay in, or even just stay in hotels because, like, we had this family that stayed in a hotel for like 3 months.
Sorry, I just got a really funny thought in my head.
What they were looking for houses. Out in Paradise Valley, I believe, to where they closed on their house and shit.
Oh,
so
they were just trying,
you know,
to.
Yeah.
So there was a. Sorry to interrupt. There was a hotel, or I guess it would have been. Would you guys consider a hotel?
Motel. Holiday Inn.
Yeah, motels are a little bit. Hotels are a little bit higher up than motels, would you say? So there was this motel back in my area. And I'm not even kidding you. The sign said, have your next affair here.
Wow. If I ran the hotel, that's what I would do.
I mean
you're making money, so like,
I mean, they're doing that for that reason anyway.
Yeah.
Like,
fuck it.
What is that guy doing when he goes out for? That guy was actually our hotel for business. Now that I think about it. And he was there for like a week. You see what I'm saying?
I mean there's all types of like different especially the internet, man. The internet's just a crazy place,
it
bro.
Is,
you know, you get lost
is.
In the sauce.
There are rabbit holes every which way.
Because you can, what the fuck was I gonna say? You can sign up for like clubs and shit on the internet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And they're maybe next door. I'm
yeah,
not gonna
like
say, you know, not too far.
You're talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure there probably are some interesting.
And it's funny though. So, all right. So, That's one thing that I remember in his faces. But for some reason, like, I don't like watching porn because it's like, I'm like, I know that girl. And it'd be so close to where it's like you can tell by like the scenery and shit like that, like palm tree. Oh shit!
Yeah. No, seriously though, because
that goes back to like what you were saying. Like you don't know, you know, 10 years, yeah. 10 years from now, you might be with that girl. You know what I'm saying?
And honestly, that's where it's like people's past is what they're is gonna be, because it's like you see those the videos that were like I just said. Then it's like, you know, those girls that y'all are wanting to where, like, they don't do anything of that nature. But maybe they've had 3 or 4 boyfriends before you that they were making videos with, and the guy wanted to put it online. And then now your Boom. Girl is out there, but she didn't really want to be. But does, like, at that point, like, does that change how you see her?
Your perspective.
Yeah. You know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, it's still out there. Mm. Like, people are seeing her naked.
No, I mean, again, yeah, it's you know the same mean? Thing so, as the Kim K. I'm sure she probably didn't want that out there, but it got out there.
Mm-hmm. And so, like, all you can do is deal with it. Like, yeah. like even with that, like, you know, when people say Kim K, like, honestly, the first thing I think of is not that.
Yeah.
It's not her sucking up Ray J. Like.
Yeah, but that definitely took some time to get that.
Honestly, it did, but I'm also one to where, like, I'm not a huge fan of Kim K.
Anymore. Yeah, I was going to say, she either. Sucks, so let's not even talk about it. She could go kick rocks.
I like Courtney or Kim.
Maybe get shot.
And so it's just, like, with that, like, you know, over time, they've built up this, like, rapport with, like, I'm going to finish it. The Kardashians, like, the show, but which is actually about to be
Yeah, it should have been done like 20 years ago.
But that's the thing, though. It's like, you know, when people are able to go off of like fear or excitement from other people's drama is what's going to sell. So that kind of goes back to us and the putting out like the WAP or, you know, different
stuff. That's what I'm saying, man.
Yeah, so people are putting stupid. It out like
you got fans. Shows. You got shows like the fucking... Remember Flavor Flav back in the day, bro?
Hey, that was that shit.
Yo, I saw something. It was so funny. It was like, bro, like it was like
that was on, that bro. Show. You can't do it was that. Like 20. Can't do that to Flavor.
That show was stupid as fuck.
It was
bro.
Like 20 women come together, and this is the prize.
But okay, but if you look at that aspect though, think about it in our terms. We're just not on TV. It's actually like that. 20 girls are trying to date one dude.
It is.
It's just not portrayed in the aspect of like.
It's so satirical too, because it's like.
What does that mean? Satirical.
Like just back ass words funny to me. Like.
I was just curious what that meant.
Or like, or like, you never heard of like satirical drama, like dry humor. But yeah, like The Bachelorette, you know, it's like, oh my God, he cheated on me. But yet you're watching a show where 20 women are trying to compete for this one dude. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, man, you know nothing matters.
Yeah, to each his own. I feel like it's weird with women, and it's weird, because I even asked Paige the same thing. I'm like, why are you watching dating shows and shit like that? But, like, women do that for some sort of, like, I guess knowledge, but also to...
What would you learn from that show?
like, from her, like, I can only speak for her. She would look at it to more of like the things that can be beneficial, like in a relationship, or the things where like they went bad, like how to like somewhat improve to make it so that, like, say her relationship or whatever doesn't go through the same thing, or you know what I mean? Like that's one of the things that like they will, well, I would say Paige would look at. And that's why I'm just like, okay, well, you're not just looking at those, you're also looking at like, there's a show called like Love on the Spectrum. There's, you know, other shows that are on there that's not just talking about 8 guys dating one girl, or one girl, or 18 girls dating one guy. It's one thing to where it's like, even for us, like, yeah, we look at porn, but it ain't just like we're looking at porn just to get to a point. Like, we are looking at the sensuality of the woman, or you know what I mean? Like, still something you can grasp from porn.
Do you guys think like in those shows, like call it Bachelorette or whatever, do you think, and again, I don't know, I probably would never want to actually go on one of those shows, do you think they're actually going on there to find love or boost their portfolio?
This is a question, great question for Ron. I hope he fucking answers this.
It's both.
Oh my God.
It is. Some of them are actually going on there for love. That's the, and that's the honest, dead honest truth. And the thing about it is that
I don't think that's being honest, man.
No, for real, I'm being honest. There's those girls that go in there for the like the dead honest love of it. And then you got those girls that are just like, okay, well, I'm gonna go here to boost myself or to boost like my business or what have you. Did it stop?
Right? No, there was no right or wrong answer. I was just curious.
Yeah. No, I mean, no.
But you heard that too. Like,
yeah,
we're good. Yeah, I don't know what the fuck
what
that was.
Nothing matters.
I think we're just fucking spitting too much fire. Dalan.
I don't know. This is just my perspective. I think maybe there might be people who have never had media or television experience prior to going on a show, and that might be their first instance. You know, if you're like fucking 34 years old and come from the sticks and have never interacted with like anyone in the world, and you're like, hey guys, I'm
you have to make videos.
I think to answer the question,
I feel like you are right. I feel like there are people who are genuinely looking for that.
I'm still disagreeing with that.
No, there really are. But
they don't know. I think some of them the magnitude of what they're getting into. Sometimes
I think if the show was made with one person with a camera and that whoever guy girl, maybe. But like the amount of jobs and the amount of work that goes into producing
like
a show it loses all
private aspect of finding
all value.
But I mean, I understand that, like what you're saying. But you know, you still have those genuine people out there. So it's like if we go into a place, and,
but that genuine person
that
is not being genuine. They're not allowed to be themselves in that show. You understand that?
But that's why a lot of those are the ones that get kicked off beforehand and shit like that, because they do want that. But that just answers the question of like you're asking, well, if there are people that go in there for the genuineness of it, and that kind of answers the question of yeah, it's just majority of them don't.
For sure. I mean.
I don't know, man.
Point A.
Nothing
like,
matters, Jordy.
It's almost kind of
like, for real,
like, yeah.
If it's 3 out of 20.
If you think
nobody's gonna remember those first three.
Yeah, but if you think
not,
like,
we're asked you asked the question.
If
of,
you think like
he
asked
the question.
No, it's all good. Yeah, I don't give a fuck. If you look at like Jersey Shore, for instance, like if you think hey guys, we're just gonna go party and you know not get popular from that, you know, you got to be out of your fucking mind. That's exactly what they did, and you know you turn it into a business. So
yeah, but most people
that's what I'm saying. That's where it loses its value. It's no longer like,
but it's
it's no longer genuine once you.
It's not the
do
same.
That, you
though.
Know what I'm saying?
It's not the
what
same.
Jersey Shore and.
And The Bachelor, that's not the same.
No, like
no,
I'm
yeah,
just
yeah,
saying,
they're
like,
definitely two different.
I feel like there's like, again, I do think there are people that probably go on and are interested in maybe, you know, seeing what online or like reality dating is kind of like, just to experience that. And there are some that go on to it just to kind of build themselves up, if you will.
So what would you do if you went on to that Titan show?
That's, you know, you're building your portfolio, basically.
What is it?
The show with The Rock.
Titan Games.
Yeah.
So it's like, again, you have to be kind of very receptive of what you do. Like, Survivor, I think, would be fucking dope. Like, where you go out on an island and compete and do games.
But to me, that would be the same thing. It's not real. Like,
it's
scripted.
I'm not going and looking for love, though.
No, but still, you're going on that show to like gain something that,
from the show,
not to go on some fucking island and hang out with some motherfuckers you don't know.
No, I'm just saying there are different like media shows and media in general.
Is the Survivor still a thing?
I think so. Yeah.
Really?
Wow. See, like,
that's like 30 years.
I tried out for Wheel of Fortune. For anyone of you guys who might not have known, yeah. It was a cool experience. I think that would be fucking sweet to be on.
I mean, those shows are drastically different.
That's what I'm saying, though. There's so many different levels of media, and like, you know, and I try to understand this because that's what I do. But like Survivor or Titan Games or something like that, you know, that's me. I'm not trying to go try and find love.
Shout out that dude, Ken, that won like 75 in a row on Jeopardy.
Yeah, that's
that
crazy.
That shit was crazy. I remember that back in the day.
Yeah, he did that shit.
I think he won like 3.5 or something like that.
Million?
Yeah.
Who knows? I feel like he won more than that, right?
That the dude from last year just beat it or something like that.
Does that dude who won 70 in a row?
Mm-hmm. Something like that, yeah. Because he was on that bitch for
the would any of you
is it the one that was always talking about his daughter?
Some white dude. That's all I remember.
Yeah, it was a white dude. He was from like Vegas or something. He was like a gambler. Yeah. He's on that bitch. Yeah. He's like, well, it's like, how much you want to bet? He was like, well, my daughter was born on the 2nd, and like he just have all these reasons.
would you guys ever try out for like any game shows or anything like that?
Nah.
No.
Maybe the Price is Right.
Yeah, Price is Right.
But it's just not the same.
I had someone in the crowd on Price is Right. Or like one of my buddies that I went to school with went on Price is Right. Like, I think, because you dress up for that shit.
No, that's that Wayne Brady one.
Yeah, Wayne Brady you can, but Price is Right you can too.
Yeah, I think you dress up for it.
I've never really seen him in costumes. They just had a colored t-shirt on and had their name. Mm-hmm.
Well, they have different events. I think some are like most of them, I think I know what you're talking about, where they just have like their little name tag. But like if it's like Halloween or something like that, I think they.
But the one Wayne Brady does, that's everybody's always dressed up.
Because it's kind of like Breakfast Club. That one is.
I've never seen that.
But no, I mean, and it's like you movie, you have to like, again,
but also the Wayne Brady show that you're talking about.
I thought you were talking about the Breakfast Club. I was like, man,
what the zoink? What is this?
You are a bitch. She said, why am I a bitch? Because you know how shitty that is to do this.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever seen that. Is that a show?
It's in the Breakfast Club. They're all in detention.
Is it a show?
It's a movie.
Came out in like the 80s. He was pissed off at her.
Dude, oh my God. One of my favorite movies, man. Fast Times at Ridgemont High. That's one of the greatest movies ever, man. Shout out, dude. Shout out. Which I think was filmed in fucking, I don't know where it was filmed.
Let's find out.
Ridgemont High? But so you said Family Feud or Family Feud? Or Price is Right.
Nah, I don't want to be hanging out with Steve Harvey's bitch ass.
All right, so Price is Right.
Yeah, Price is Right.
The Price is Wrong, but, bitch.
But the newer Price Right, Drew Carey. Or
yeah,
the old
no, one? That's what I'm saying. The old one, like it ain't the same. Like it ain't the same with fucking. Yeah. Shout out Cleveland, Ohio.
Now with Drew Carey,
or Toledo.
I'll get on the show. Fucking
yeah, that's a good one. Off the top. Like Wayne Brady. He was Wayne Brady in that, wasn't he? Yeah.
Wayne Brady.
What, did he change his name or something?
Who? No.
Wayne Brady.
Yeah, he was in there. He was the only black
guy. Yeah, but did he change his name or something?
No, he's always been Wayne Brady.
He was just like, he was Wayne Brady in that. Like, what do you mean he was Wayne Brady? Wayne Brady is. But he's like, he was.
Wayne Brady,
I was about to ask him, does Wayne Brady have to smack a bitch?
That was a good show. I liked
Chappelle Show.
Who's line? That was at Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? That was a good one.
Oh, well, who is it? Regis?
Regis. Shout out Regis. He passed away not too long
ago. He died?
He croaked.
He croaked. How old was he?
I don't know.
Damn, man. R.I.P. Regis.
Actually, but it was,
this one's for you, Regis.
But it is crazy.
It was different ones that did.
Yeah, I think there were a couple ones. But it is crazy, though, to think about that, though. Like, you know, you
dying?
Got, yeah.
I don't really want to think about that.
Like, Alex Trebek, like, I love the dude. Like,
Alex Jones?
Trebek. For Jeopardy. Like, He beat pancreatic cancer, I'm pretty sure, and I don't know if they're still airing them or not. I hope they still are, because
Jeopardy,
the man's a legend. But it is just crazy. Like, that's like your epitome of like a fucking your regular, you know, citizen superhero.
See, that's cool shit, man.
Yeah.
See, but like if you grow up nowadays, you just don't have shit like that. Like you got fucking, you got what? You said the Kardashians or something?
Kardashians, yeah. Yeah.
Fucking gay, dude.
Yeah.
Fucking suck, man.
That is, No,
I think the biggest thing now is just that everyone is using whatever platform it is to get ahead, and that's the problem. Like in the past, all this shit has happened. You know what I mean? No one just never ever used that as a stepping stone to get them to make more money or bigger in the company or anything like that. Nowadays, it's so much free speech. It's so much where people are sensitive and shit like that.
Jordy ain't trying to hear this.
Yeah, people are sensitive.
Yeah, Jordy's sensitive, man.
Do you guys think there should be regulation? I mean, and it's not possible, but do you guys think there should be regulations on like media?
Like, what do you mean?
Like, just I don't know. Again, I guess just it's like because it's, again, it's just like, you know, again, we grew up, you know, watching, you know, what, Jeopardy, Wheel of Fortune, or whatever.
Arthur.
You know, Arthur.
I'm gonna get Arthur. That's gonna be one of my next tattoos is Arthur.
Yeah, I bet that'd be fucking sweet. Get it like a Biggie bandana or something like that. Yeah. Hey, or put the Franklin. Franklin was fucking dope. I don't know. I just I feel like media can sometimes get away from us.
Shout out Stocky, bro. What were you saying?
No, I'm just saying I feel like sometimes, you know, again, everyone has a cell phone. You know, you can record whatever the fuck you want, and there's no regulation or anything of anyone telling you that this is right or wrong.
Mm-hmm.
So I just wasn't, you know, up in the air, you know, question.
But what? But what was the question?
Like, what I'm like,
I was waiting for it.
Do you think there should be like group? I mean, and I guess I'm just answering my own question. It's not possible at this point, but I'm just thinking, like, you know, what your guys' thoughts on are if there should be like groups that, like make sure this is the right thing to put out or this isn't the right thing to put out. And I know that it's basically like I already answered my own question. That's not possible because anyone and everyone can upload whatever they want.
You're asking if there should be.
Yeah, like
regulations, I feel like there is regulations on. You only see what they want you to hear, right?
Ooh, who's that?
The fucking Illuminati, man.
Yeah, pretty much.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, I mean, y'all joke about it like it's fake. This shit's real.
Yeah.
Hey, man. don't shoot the messenger. You know.
You're the Illuminati messenger.
But like the easiest thing to hide is to hide it in plain sight.
Black Transformers.
Mirror. Black Mirror.
Robots in the sky.
Yeah, but Transformers.
They're just we even just talked about the whole you said you're gonna watch it and I'm gonna just tell Gabe that you said you're gonna watch it.
The platform?
No.
I forgot how to do it. Dude, Ash comes over one time. I don't think nobody else is here but me and Jordy. And he's like, Jordy comes in all juiced up. He's like, dude, Ash, you gotta watch Platform. It's a fucking crazy movie. Check it out on Netflix. Like, bro, I was just like losing it, man. I was like, holy shit.
Man, that damn movie.
Yeah, that movie was fucked.
But really, like,
oh, oh yeah, 100%.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
Like, it's society.
Yeah,
it's society now.
It's exactly. And then that girl that's going up and down the platform, she's a whistleblower.
But the thing about it is like she's, hold on, she wasn't a whistleblower.
She was going through and saying that her daughter was there. Nobody's like, there's no kids there.
But she wasn't a whistleblower because she actually had a daughter that was down there.
Well, yeah, but she's the one that's blowing the whistle, saying that. Bringing attention to all the bad shit that was there.
Yeah.
I see what you're saying. Okay, yeah. I can see that. But that goes to tell you that, for an example, and I want to go further into this, but Black Lives Matter. If Black Lives Matter did not stay apart as long as it has, a lot of this shit that's coming up about the government and shit like that would have never came up. But this has been going on for, like, you know, years and shit like that. That's why I was even talking to you, like, you know, Trayvon Martin, it literally stopped. Some shit was coming out, but it stopped. And for them to continue to Black Lives Matter, more and more shit comes up. Like, do you think that the Epstein shit would have just been so, like, I understand it wasn't as big as it should have been, but Like, do you think
that is nowhere near what it should be?
You see what I'm saying? Yeah. But a lot
because
of that
again, you still don't hear anything about.
But
Keen
a lot of that
Maxwell.
Came to light based off of that, based off of the whole Black Lives Movement, and so that just shows you that the whole Black Lives Matter wasn't just about like, the skin color does matter, but it's the bigger picture of the injustice that everybody's seeing. Mm-hmm. So when we talked about Breonna Taylor, and she, the dude that killed her or the police that killed her, they get charged for the damage done to the apartment around their apartment. Mm-hmm. They didn't get charged for anything that had to do with her. So that just shows you, once again, like how fucked up our system is. Mm-hmm. And it's not necessarily just that it's doing it to Black people, it's doing it to white Mexicans or whoever it is. We just need to, it's just, I feel like it's just, like I said, the Black Lives Movement is putting light to a lot of other shit that light wouldn't have been put on.
I got a question for you, Ron. Mm-hmm.
Go ahead and answer it. Go ahead and ask it, because you know I'm going to answer it.
Now.
Say it. Mm-hmm. Go ahead. Don't be over here.
Well, no, like, I'm already a few conversations down the road, because I was just thinking what you had said.
About to say.
So
he's formulating his thoughts.
Yeah. Because Black Lives Matter, right? Uh-huh. So say the people covering up this and that, like a majority of people will say that they're white, right?
That are covering up
like just all the fucked up shit that's going on.
That doesn't necessarily mean that they're just white.
No, I'm saying that the people that are doing it are white. Say that's what majority of people would say, right?
You're talking about like the Antifa.
I'm just saying like the people that are basically like fucking a lot of the shit up are white. Correct? Is that what you would now?
Somewhat. Because I just the reason why I say that is because I just know there's some fucked up Black people in
right.
In
okay.
Shit
perfect.
Too.
So that was gonna be kind of my next thing. Like, so what? I guess what about everything that's going on would change if we think that whoever's in control of all this shit is white, but it's actually a Black person.
You know what's funny? You know what's funny? Now did you say that? I'm not even gonna make the statement. Actually, I will. If you actually, and the reason
I love this, like, honestly, this is the shit that I need to hear.
And honestly, I would actually say this: the problem has been somewhat Black people.
Yeah, I mean, there's no denying.
And the reason being, the reason being is the factor where it's like, if you go back to anything, you know, we've started it for the most part, different things. And I will say this just about the Republican Party. It was started by Black people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because I remember we had
like
that conversation.
Everything that black people have literally came up with their own, white people have stolen from them. And so that's why I always think like the ideologies of Republicans are just the thoughts that Black people kind of had back in those times. You see what I'm saying? So mm-hmm. if there was the Black Republicans back in the day, you know, the biggest thing for like Black people were to work their ass off to get what they wanted, well, what they needed, because they didn't have that extra, you know, assistance on the outside. So it was always basically like, we're going to work our ass off to get our shit, basically. And so when it was kind of taken over, then it was kind of like, I feel like it was one of those things where they got on the other side to kind of down the people that
didn't make it.
So it's kind of like how Americans down Britain so fucking much, but you are a product of where you came from.
Mm-hmm. that just kind of came to me.
Yeah, I think it's every race. I just think that, in a sense, it's just that certain white demographics have learned to control it better,
mm-hmm.
or control people in their minds. I'm gonna find it just to send it to you. But this goes back to like Rockefeller and shit. Like, you know, you got all these big families that are like the white 1%ers and shit like that. And then you gotta think about it. Like, they're family members that are trickled down and shit like that. They probably have the same ideologies that, you know, they did once before. And one of the things was like in the video, the guy was basically telling you all the things you needed to do to control America, and every single thing that he named off has happened within since that video came out and now. Every fucking thing that's happened, from the brainwashing of people to all of it. They literally was already talking about it back in the 20s. Like, this is how you can control a race or just a whole demographic.
Just the people as a whole.
Mm-hmm. It's like, you put out this.
Fear and division.
Fear and division, but it's not, it doesn't really, have you ever seen fear and division work with white people?
I mean, it's working with everyone right now.
Have you ever seen it work with white people? Within themselves. Have you ever seen another white person really mad or upset about themselves or them come up with something about white people?
I can't answer
put each one into a category, in a sense, to make them have some sort of separation.
It's on like 39.
Oh shit, it's right there.
I'll leave it. Yeah, I mean, I'm just I can't even answer that.
Weren't you because that baby? So and shit,
the reason why I say that is because like most of the time it's easier to vie people that are already in turmoil. Mm-hmm. So the black community doesn't have like an identity in a sense. So the easiest thing to get certain ones to conform is to spread that fear and division.
Yeah.
So that's one thing where it's like, when it comes down to, see, that's why I need you fuckers to watch the Great Hack. Oh, what the hell y'all is tripping on?
Fuckers, like, what are we getting? Is this a race thing? I don't know.
No, it's his ass too.
I've been watching House of Cards.
Yeah, that shit's good. The reason why I say this is because you two are the fuckers that talk so much about social media that y'all don't go and look at the video that's talking about social media. And the
I watched the Social Dilemma.
I don't have Netflix though, which is like
ironic. That's right. It's on the TV, man.
Well, I'm talking about it.
It's on the Xbox.
It's on the Xbox.
You have my Xbox.
Not anymore.
No, well, that's what I'm saying. I asked
that question. I think I might have told you guys before.
Right here, these are in my list: The Great Hack and The Social Dilemma.
The reason why I say it is because until you get more information on it, don't really speak about social media until you get that information from a lot of the information from the movies. Because the reason why I say it, I hope I didn't say it into like the wrong way or anything like that. It's just that a lot of the stuff that you talk about is covered, or they dive deeper into it, so then you know a little bit more about like the social media aspect. Like The Great Hack goes more into the cybersecurity and stuff like that, whereas The Social Dilemma is basically talking about just like the apps and shit like that. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So Social Dilemma The Great Hack is talking more about like the whole internet as a whole. Mm-hmm. It's not talking about just certain platforms. Like the internet as a whole is shit, because you have no rights, you have no rights, I have no rights, you have no rights. So at the end of the day, if I want to be some person that's right next to you looking at you, I could be typing over here stealing all your fucking money.
You think we should do the Face ID thing? A lot of people think that's like
I don't think so. I just think it's just one tool.
What about the fingerprint?
I'm cool with the fingerprint. The only reason why I'm cool with the fingerprint, because it's one thing where it's like, with your fingerprint, like, yeah, it's with you the rest of your life, but like, people notice you more about your face than your fingerprint.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, Ron, I asked you that question because I thought about this girl that I met in college, and she happened to be black, right? Mm-hmm. And she, I don't know her story, she sucks, but I'll say her name like maybe a different time. Mm-hmm. But
you can say initials or whatever, but fuck her, I guess.
What is her initials? A she I want to say AS.
Sorry, Ashley.
No, actually, now that you say that, that's her first name. Yeah, but she sucked. So, but yeah, she was black, right? And one time, like, I got introduced to her.
Wait, what do you mean she was black?
Hopefully she's dead. Yeah.
Well, you know, I guess it's 2020. You know, there's many changes that have been happening.
Hopefully she's dead. But I got introduced to her from some homies. And she came over to our house.
I'm no longer friends with these homies.
Well, kind of, like, yeah, I was just like, what the fuck? But, yeah, she came over to our house, and, like, I was just so confused at like what the fuck she was saying, because she's clearly black, and she's just saying like all this negative shit about black people. I hate black people, and all that shit. But I just started thinking about that. Then I was thinking about what if like there's a black person controlling all the fucking chaos right now. But that's all.
I mean, fuck her.
Interesting.
I mean, it's an interesting insight of that.
I mean, I feel like within any race, you're gonna get those ones that dislike their own fucking race or whatever.
But that's just insane. I don't even.
This might be a tough one.
I feel like you should just like that person should just leave. You know, just end it.
This one's gonna be a tough one because it's like, you know, again, like obviously we're all sitting here collectively. But do you think racism will ever go away or sexism will ever go away? My answer is no. Because it's like we're sitting here having this collective conversation just fine, but you put
different you change one person and it might be George in this thing, it might light on fire.
Like even for me, like I know, I was like at his house where I was I'm sure yeah. you guys know black people that have never had any conversation or interaction with a white person or any other race, and I'm sure we know white people that have never had any interaction with any other type of race, and that's the unfortunate part of the world.
I don't think I've ever met any white person. Like, I've never talked to a black person. I mean, you go to school.
You go to work. Well, okay, yeah. I'm talking about like a deep, you know, like, hey, let's go get lunch. Like, let's actually like go get to know each. You know, obviously you're gonna be forced to have some minute interaction with a different race in this world.
As far as like media,
in terms of the depth in which people want to take it.
Yeah, I mean, as far as like media and shit, there's a lot of naive, just foolishness being passed around. So to answer your question, nah, nothing's going away.
I would say
nothing's changing. Nothing matters.
The only way that it would change is if people become more open minded.
I agree. That's what I was thinking.
And that's where the thing of like, you know, even with you, like I think we had this conversation when you were back home. But it's like with you in the position that you're in, you're in the most prime position that you don't know that you're in right now. You're gonna be, you and the people that you speak to are gonna be the face, even Jordy, are gonna be the face of America in some years. You see what I'm saying? And if y'all don't, in a sense, kind of have these conversations with other people, like of your same skin color, then yes, that's where we're gonna be.
No, and it goes everywhere, you know. And this is something, you know, I think is crucial. It's like,
but hold on, what do you mean by it goes everywhere? You gotta elaborate on that.
Like, yeah, I mean, we have to definitely have, you know, it's not just white, you know, white, black, it's just as a collective whole, you have to be kind of...
Yes, but it's more white people.
No, I agree.
Because y'all, white people have that privilege. No, and I honestly, Jordy, you got a privilege too.
He about to pull up from that.
But he still got the privilege though. Because at the end of the day, if he was like, all right, I'm turning my life around, and then it's like, oh, I'm working, I want to get my credit, like, he will get a credit card or another thing, anything like that, before somebody that was of my complexion. So that's why I say the privilege still works. You got people that do bad stuff, but the privilege works for you guys. Like, it doesn't work for me. I can't go out here and, you know, kill somebody or do anything like that and then be like, oh, well, I'm going to get 2 years probation. You get 2 years probation. I get 40 years. You're so stupid.
I get 5 years of jaywalking. I don't know about you, but shit.
But I just feel like that.
No, I agree. But I do think ignorance comes in all shapes, sizes, and colors.
Well, it does. But for you not... For you basically saying that just shows that you think that you're not the one that should be trying to change things. Kind of like we had the conversation in here, and I kind of was just like, there's no point in me talking about it anymore. Because
no,
you,
I agree.
Hold on. You, like you say you agree, but the what comes after doesn't say that you agree. Like you're agreeing with everything that, like everybody doing it, but you're not going to accept the fact that it starts with you. You see what I'm saying? Because all this starts with you. Like, conversations. Like, even when we had the conversations in here about, you know, everything. Like, white people don't really... Well, I feel like white people have conversations about race. But we have... I feel like in the in like home, we have more conversations about race from when we were born.
I mean...
You know what I mean?
I think a great way for... holy shit, I think I might have lost my thought.
I may have said it wrong, but I just think that with the like with that privilege, that a lot of those people aren't open minded to the new things that they are they're encompassing. You see what I'm saying? So with the new wave of all this, that's why like even the video, there was a video of a white girl that her and her parents were going back and forth because her parents were giving out these lame ass statistics of, oh, black people are this, black people are that. Then her mom or her the daughter was like, why do you think black people are there? It's because of white people. Like, you systemically push them down, and then you make like it's like you holding somebody down and then laugh at them because they're down, but then you want them to be like, oh, you're supposed to proper, like, you got your foot on my fucking neck.
I think that video sounds cool. I kind of want to watch it.
He's like, no, like, for real, like, she was literally like that. The girl was into it. She said her mom gave a statistic, and then she's like, well, actually, mom, you're a little wrong because it's so. Then her mom's like, yeah, right. So she's like, no, mom, like, literally listen to me. And then her mom's like, just shut up. And then her dad gets into it, and then she's talking to her dad.
Yeah.
But that's the thing, like,
no, it's that
those
mentality.
Are the hard think, conversations yeah, that you no, need to have. Because
I think,
no, I'm done.
I think a great way for Eric and people like Eric to understand and really like think about things is how different a conversation is with or without us in the room. That's all. And that might take a while to sink in. So just let it marinate. You smell what I'm stepping in, man?
So this is just me answering. You're asking me if you two weren't here and...
Say not necessarily Jordy, but just like say, like anybody really, you know? I think a conversation is... drastically different. Not drastically. It definitely depends on the scale. Like not necessarily drastically for you, but it is somewhat different than it would be with or without us is what I'm saying.
Again, and I think it depends on the person though.
Yeah, because, yeah, and because, then like, again
because,
there's levels.
Like, I even told Ron like the one day, like it was after I think it was after Jacob Blake, after that incident had happened. I called my buddy that Artrell. I told you that, and I asked him. I was like, you know, and this is obviously no one that you guys even know, and he's black. And that's just something, you know. And I told him, I was like, kind of the same thing we're having right here, you know, just talking. Like, how do we like, or you know, and just I guess just as a collective whole to like better, but it's like. You know, and what you said though, unfortunately, I don't think this is gonna get, or like just racism and sexism is a thing that is just pushed, like, unfortunately, and people don't want to change, or like people are unfortunately not changing. And it's not everyone, but you get pockets of people like just that, again, don't want to have these conversations.
That's true. And that's why a lot of times I've been basically saying, like, you know, these hard conversations need to happen.
I agree. Because I feel uncomfortable sometimes, but yeah.
But
like, what do you mean? You feel uncomfortable?
Because I feel like for me, like, I try to be as adaptable as possible and as understanding to different backgrounds and walks of life, like, regardless, you know, black or white or Mexican. Trans or whatever, you
know, shout out to all the trannies,
but you're gonna get the vast majority of people do not want to have an open mind and have these conversations. You good there?
I was burping. I was like, he had
too many white claws. He's getting into that blackout mode.
I wasn't trying to burp into the mic.
Oh yeah, I was. Well, you just like kept going. I was like, damn, is he good? I don't know.
No, I like for me, I try and be as receptive to the information that is brought to me, so that I can change properly. But again, it's like there's so many people that don't want to do that.
One thing I remember that we talked about is that you said you hate controversy, or you hate arguments and stuff like that.
Confrontation. Yes. Yeah, because usually people cannot have a civil talk like this, and it escalates. That's the thing that I don't like.
Well, it just goes back. Everybody's like sensitive and shit, you know. Yeah. But I feel like for you to say that you're uncomfortable is like not how it should be, right?
I feel that too. What I'm saying? It's like are you comfortable about the conversation, or are you comfortable about the response that you're gonna get from us?
I'm not.
You know what I mean?
Like, it's not you. Like it's I guess like the actions of if you. Like people, like again, like the sensitivity—that's a very big word. You know, people can't take information if it's right. Again, back to the what you were just no, like the daughter. You know, it's that mentality. It's like where you—if someone gives you information and they can't process it, and it's an immediately like no, fuck you, you're wrong. That's the type of mentality that's not good. And then that's the confrontation type of thing.
I know
that is hard.
Yeah,
because it's like I have no problem having difficult conversations if they're conversations. Mm. But the minute it goes after conversation to confrontation is the difficult part.
I know we said that like the open-mindedness thing.
Mm-hmm.
But like one thing I will compliment this whole like society on is making progress towards that. We're not like anywhere near what it should be, but there is like a growing open-mindedness somewhat.
Are you basing that off of just like from like when frame?
Because I mean you can say that same thing in the 60s
to where it's like pushing forward. Yeah. In the 60s they were thinking like, man, this is doing something.
I mean, do you think it happens every 4 years?
No, I was going to say definitely within like the last 5. I would say that things have. I'm also not really speaking for like race. I'm speaking more for like the trans thing and all
that's
that.
That's what
as
I was
well.
About to. And that's what I was just about.
Because
to ask you.
Now it's just getting.
So it's like even with that, it's like you know you still. I feel like with you saying that, and then within that time frame, it's been more about like the Me Too movement, the you know, gay people, LGBTQ. So
that's the name of this episode. Me Too.
So it's just like in the last 5 years, that's been a huge thing. And so like,
yeah.
I feel like only because of that
has it changed
people to be more open-minded, because it's like you literally have to be open-minded about somebody's sexual orientation. You know what I mean? Because more likely than not, somebody within your family.
What is oriented like choice? Right? Orientation?
I honestly don't even know, because it's like...
Is sexual orientation gay?
It's just whatever really you... Know. It's like... I feel like...
Identify
just,
as.
Yeah.
But the... Like whatever you so identify the, as.
Oh, like male,
so
female.
I don't like... I don't know if you guys have seen in California. There was something about... obviously, you guys have probably been seeing like the whole pedophilia thing. There was something in California, if I'm not mistaken, and I'll have to look further into it, that was a law passed, or they were trying to pass it, how grown adults, if they feel like they're younger that day, that it's acceptable to be with someone under 18.
And what the fuck?
Yeah.
Where'd you see this?
I didn't see that.
It was in.
I seen something about they let rapists out early or something. But
yeah, yeah, that's the I saw something like.
Kelly is on fire.
I just have to look at it more, but that was just something that I had seen quickly. again, I don't know if it's right or wrong.
I mean, back to the sexual orientation thing. Okay, so the only thing that pisses me off about that is the growing, like, indecisiveness of this current generation. That is all that is, bro. You do not want to be held accountable for any actions. Mm-hmm. Therefore, you say you may have a boyfriend, but maybe that girl's looking pretty nice. I want to be bi. And I don't want to be held accountable for my actions. Therefore, I want to declare myself bi.
So that you can...
So that I can continue to do whatever I want with no repercussions.
Mm-hmm. Instead of being like, oh, I'm gay. Or
instead of choosing... So, which goes back to another problem with this generation. After I just complimented him, I got a fucking shit on you guys or us, I guess. But I am not a part of you guys because you guys suck. So I cannot stand this generation's indecisiveness. Everybody's scared to make a fucking decision. Like, nobody can even choose where to go, what to do. Being so scared that it is going to be the wrong decision when there is no wrong decision. No one knows what the fuck they're doing. Stop being a bunch of bitches.
And the thing about that, too, is that, like, people are literally going off of, you know, like you said, like, social media and shit. It's like you see somebody else doing something and it's like, oh, I'm going to go do that.
Yeah.
But then you didn't really choose it on your own. You chose it because somebody else chose it.
We need to have, like, segments in this, and I'm just going to start dropping fucking bombs on these stupid-ass motherfuckers, man.
So when they hear this in 10 years, they're going to be like, wow. Yeah.
So when my kids hear this,
they'll have some...
Daddy was a G.
Daddy was a G.
I don't know, man. You pissed me off, Ron, and I've just been firing off ever since.
I feel that, though, because, like, I think it's indecisiveness, but people are more easily and receptive to be...
told what to do.
No, to play the victim.
Yeah.
So it's like... So it's like you got all these Karens that, you know, can stop you and get in your fucking business.
Shout out Karen.
And then do all this other shit. And then you smack her ass. And,
oh, my God. I'm coming to Karen. This shit that happened out here?
At the gas station. I saw that. That was a couple months ago.
Yeah, but like just situations, it was. Yeah, just it was, situations huh? like that. It's like, why are you even...
Go back. Why is Karen even talking to that girl, bro?
I think it was like where it was like, go back to your country. It's like, I was born here, you fucking idiot. Like,
yeah,
she's
stupid.
But it's just stupid shit like that. And then it's like, you know, even when we play the video game, and then you got like people in here just like, you know, somebody loses by 2 points in the game, and then they're just like, oh, fuck you, you suck, you're stupid ass. Like, it's like, for what? What is that making you gain? Like, or play a fucking video game, regardless if you're programmer, gamer or not, like, it's still a video game. Like, you died in the game, didn't you? Okay, cool. Like,
but did you die?
But did you really die? But it's like, it's just stuff like that. And so, one of the things is, it's just like...
This has been a good one, man.
I've been trying... I've literally been trying.
I think we're going on close to 3 hours, probably.
Yeah, I think we're at two right now.
But I'm just trying to get that to not happen, because I know there's so many other people that are not as, you know, don't have as thick a skin as me or anything like that. And when you say something to them, it just sticks to their ass.
That's the issue, man.
And so that's why sometimes, like, you know, I really don't care, but it's just like if I know you. I'm not going to say certain shit because you're going to take it
offensive
and run with it. And, you know what I mean?
So, but certain things you can't really say. It's just the person, too, for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, definitely a person.
But I mean, just like you were saying,
and just the experiences that you've gone through in life, too.
Let me say this.
Or, I guess, not experience, the lack thereof.
Well, I mean, it could be the lack thereof, but...
Could be experiences, too, really.
Well, I mean, it could, but I feel like that's an excuse. You know what I mean?
Because, at least, like, the decision was made.
Yeah, because, like... I fucking feel that.
Oh, shit. I thought something was fucking crawling on me, man. I was fucking freaking out.
Rico, where'd you come from, Rico?
I was like, what the fuck is that?
You better be bringing Rico and Suki over here one day. I haven't seen them in 2.5 months.
Yeah. I can't remember. What did I tell you to do, Eric? Listen. Something about races. Oh, if we weren't in the room, what did you think about that comment?
In terms of like the conversation that we're having right now,
or just any conversation?
Could I have this conversation with other people of different colors or races?
However you want to take it, we'll go wherever you want to go. You just got to decide.
I mean, like again, it's. Well, okay, elaborate on that.
I would just answer no questions. That's the thing.
I can't remember what was the question.
But then, didn't you have a question too, or?
Did you have a question? No, I'm asking what you think about what I said about how different it would be if we were or were not in the room.
So, I agree because everyone has different perspectives. Everyone has their different mindset. If it was two, you know, if you were Mexican or Asian, you're gonna have two different understandings of the world. So it's like. You have to adapt to who you're talking to and the experiences that they've.
But should you? Should you even?
That they're providing you to have a conversation.
Okay, but like, should you even have to adapt? And why can't you just?
What do you mean?
I just didn't really care for your answer, to be honest. Like, you don't like to like. What do you mean adapt? Like, you don't need like.
The information that is provided to you in conversation from other people is the how you react to what you're gonna say.
Right, but
because if you're white and you're white, we're gonna have two different conversations. Like,
yeah,
because
but why can't we just have the same conversations? Is what I'm saying.
That's a great fucking question.
Yeah. So what do you think about that? Because your answer just showed that my.
That is the problem.
That's the problem.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Your answer just showed the problem.
Okay. I'm telling you that because again, I have, again, people that I've gone to school with that would not be sitting here with you guys. So,
same.
I'm giving you that answer. Like, people are just not willing to sit down and have a fucking full blown conversation are having. Again,
shout out Jordy, shout out Steph.
If you're white, if you're Mexican, you know, or Mexican, like I'll talk to you about, you know, the hardships that you're going through in terms of your, you know, heritage coming up and how do you cope with that, you know?
That's what we're saying. Like, why should that matter? Why does the hardships and stuff come when you see people of color, but when you see somebody that's white that's sitting right there, the same questions as the guys?
Oh, he's not, he won't even say it. Like, what? Don't shake your head. I'm like,
because you're not answering the question.
Yes,
you said
I am.
He's deflecting, huh?
I understand that he's not right here. I know that there's not.
What do you want me to say? That white people are racist? Like,
no, I'm not saying that. I'm asking you why does that same shit the same conversation that we have doesn't happen when you're sitting there with say two white people?
Yeah, that's what it comes down to, man.
I mean, it happens. Like, I don't have podcast, you know.
You're looking at the podcast, you're looking at all that. We're talking about just regular conversations. If you've seen somebody in the gym that was a black dude that you really didn't have any conversation, like, didn't know for real, you still have a conversation with him about
all the shit, all the shit that's going on. It's okay. Everybody, we're two hours deep, guys. We're 2 hours deep. Everybody, calm the fuck down.
Like, how I can, like,
I'm trying to help you too. You trying to throw it off the backboard to me right now, and I'm fucking struggling. But it's all right.
Because I'm a little worried right now. The conversations are like different.
So all right, they are different because it's just the develop, you know, how people go through in life, and again the experiences and what you are exposed to and the people that you interact with. That formulate your thoughts. So if I have, you know, white friends, and I have white friends that don't have interactions with people of different backgrounds and different colors, they're gonna say the N-word or this or that. Mm-hmm. And I've literally said, dude, like, what the fuck? Like, why? Like, why? Like, why do you even need to say that? And he's like, oh, it's just a word. I have friends and roommates that are black. Like, I'm, what? Like, it's frustrating as fuck. Like,
but I mean, that's a good conversation. That's a good conversation to have. But it stemmed from.
But I'm just saying, like, spot like
of him actually saying something that you didn't like. But it's like, if we were talking right here and we're having this conversation and we're just nothing bad ever happened or you didn't have to correct anything, why can't that conversation still happen? Why is it not happening?
I was gonna ask the same thing. I was following along. Right.
The words I didn't.
I went off the rails a little bit.
So thank you. All I'm saying is that why are you not having that same conversation with your friend without it being something that had to stem from you correcting him? Why can't the conversation just happen? Period.
Mm. Okay. So basically what he's saying is, like, why these conversations should be happening, like, regularly. So why should even the situations that have happened, why should, because they're such, like, a hot topic, why does it take for this shit to happen for the conversation to be had? Right?
Yeah.
I don't fucking know.
Yeah, I don't.
But I mean, you're saying like you don't know, but like it's you, like even when
it's
we
not
sit
me.
There,
I'm
what
not
I'm saying,
the one.
Because it is what? You are the one of the ones in the conversation. This is what's pissing me off. You are in the conversation. You're basically blaming it on everybody else. You need to take responsibility for you. So have a conversation with somebody else without having to be like, oh, you used the N-word and that's bad. Now we're gonna conversate about the shit. Yeah, talk to them regularly any other time about the shit. That's what I'm saying. So that's where it comes down to the hard conversation that I've been telling you for the last like 2 months. Those are the conversations. You don't have to have something happen for it to work out in that way to be like, oh, well, I feel like this is a good time to talk. No, have those conversations when the emotions are not in.
Just even little shit, just like checking in and shit, you know, like for somebody to like say like those kind of words, because this is currently happening in a situation in my life. So just... yeah, just regularly, like,
what do you mean by that?
I mean, we could talk about it off. Yeah, I just don't want it to be recorded.
Right.
But yeah, I feel like just checking in, really, man. Just for somebody to feel so comfortable saying like those type of words, to me, clearly shows something ain't right. So. If you have had that conversation, maybe checking in, like, yo, have you spoke to anybody not white? Shit like that. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. I don't know if that...
that helped. That definitely does help. It just, it's like, even for me, like...
I mean, I understand what you're saying, but it's like, you know, you can't just be teacher to everyone all the time.
No, you can't.
So, I mean, it's not being teacher, but it's conversation. It's knowledge that's pushing you ahead. Like,
no,
when we sat right there, all the stuff that you finally looked up, I've been new. And I've literally
been
telling you verbatim everything that you said.
No, I agree with you. And I'm just saying, but like, if I go and I'm just saying, hey, you know, I can't, I'll have no, I won't even have a life. Like,
how about this? How about this? So say, how of the people that you used to interact with, like how many of them were white? Would you say?
Growing up or through college?
No, just like now, just like day to day.
When I come back here, not many.
No, I'm saying before all this, like, cause now it's kind of like, you know,
10, 15.
So what Ron is saying is just like even just having like conversations about either current events and shit going on like with those people will help change the issue is that what you're saying?
Mm-hmm.
And just taking advantage of those like one-on-one opportunities rather than it getting to such a global fucking issue. for it to become a topic, you know.
No, I agree. Like and you know, you can try and
you can
but all I'm saying is you can try to have these conversations with people. But if you go back to what you were talking about with the daughter and the mother and the father, a lot of people
just shut it up.
Not want to fucking have that conversation.
But I mean, but at that point, are you like trying to keep that friendship or that person into your life, or do you see that as like your way to be like, okay, well, I know what this person's somewhat about? Because like I've like literally like when people think in a certain way, like I've somewhat cut them off, like because there's like. If you're gonna get upset with me when I'm trying to like have a conversation with you, and or if it's something that you're trying to learn, like don't get like an attitude or anything like that. Like I understand it's gonna be heated, you know what I mean. But at the end of the day, I just feel like for me, when having that conversation, yes, people get upset. I guess yeah, I'm a little bit different because I just know that a lot of the times when it comes to certain things, people are passionate about it because until you have that talk with them, then you will finally hear that hurt in their voice or what have you. You know what I mean? And so that's where a lot of times, even for myself, I tell you this, like, there's some shit, like, I'm passionate. This is a little bit ago. I said that with passion. Like, that is just how it's said. So do you back down and walk away because I said something with passion? And you see what I'm saying? It's like sometimes those conversations are going to be hard. Like, I've had conversations where I was just, like, you know, kind of like, damn, this motherfucker. Mad as fuck, like, you know what I mean? But there's still a conversation that needs to be had. Like, I've been called nigger by white people, even the people that are friends of the family that I was cool with. I've been in different situations out in the boonies by my damn self. Could all people, they talking about how they want to whoop my ass and I could have ended up dead. You see what I'm saying? But like, I put myself in those situations to get an understanding of other things. So I do talk to them and have conversations without it being something that's bad. Just talking about, you know, like white people or whatever, just to get more knowledge for myself. And so the knowledge that I've gained for myself within those conversations, when I went to Bama and then I got my uncle, and literally you can go back now and my brother was, we'd be like, oh, them fucking crackers and all that shit, and I'm the one that's educating them on this, even though my uncle is gonna get pissed off or whatever. I don't care. I'm giving you that, having that conversation with you, and if you don't want to change your opinion, at least I'm still trying to educate you on that.
No, I agree. Like, I do this. I mean, I'm not going to, like, yell at people, be like, yo, fuck you, like, because, again, people are going to, you know, unfortunately have their own fucking thoughts, but you can educate to a certain extent, but people are still have to willingly and openly want to change, even with the information that you're giving them.
What Ron is saying is just basically with you being you and who you are, you have the...
I don't know if that's a good or a bad thing.
Yeah, I don't really know. I was just kind of going with it.
No, my thing, though...
Just
like,
that you have the opportunity that some don't, yes. So you need to use that opportunity to help push forward.
I agree, and I try to do that in the best mannerism that I possibly know, and that is.
But also to go off what you guys are saying, there is clearly a fucking generational gap between us and our parents, and
there is
a major difficulty expressing any opinions opposite of how they feel
to a higher.
But see, that's the thing. Like you're. That's kind of like beating a dead horse. Like, we already know that when people get to a certain age, even our parents, they're stuck in their way. The whole aspect.
I'm not saying that you can't talk to them. I'm just saying that Eric is saying that it is extremely difficult to get your point across to
someone who's not even willing to accept new ideas.
So again, what Eric is saying, why take the time if Eric is talking and then this dude's just like da, 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 the whole time he's talking, he's not even listening to what he's saying. You know what I'm saying?
I'll just say this, Ron. Ron has met one of the few people that I still keep in contact with, Castle.
Yeah.
Shout out Castle, man. Son of a bitch.
There is a reason why I brought him out here, because he could interact with different people of different backgrounds and different ideals. I have many other people that I probably would not bring out here because of that.
Well, I mean, I understand it, but that's,
but like, I still have those conversations with those people. But
like, at the end of the day, that's still your friend. And at the end of the day, like, if I have a friend come out here, I wish my friend would try to disrespect anybody that I'm close to. Like, because at the end of the day, like, I talk to you. Like, loyalty and friendship is a big-ass thing to me, and that's a respect thing. You know what I mean? Like, I'm giving like, I came, I had you come out here, and you do a certain shit, like, fuck you in that aspect.
And then,
like,
that's just to to go off what he's saying, like, almost to a point, if you're, if you knowingly are aware of how somebody feels about, like, race, race or whatever, and you don't agree with that, that's, like, a pretty big thing to, like, not agree on. And it kind of, I feel like it affects, it definitely plays a role in, like, that person's character, you know? So, like, me, why the fuck would I want to be around that, you know? So... Yeah, that, I don't know. That's just
no. I mean,
I don't
again,
really,
I can't. That's just kind of something as you grow up with. So obviously, you've grown. You know, you've grown up with someone for, you know, 18, 20 years.
Mm-hmm.
You go off for the next 8 to 10 years, and you get different ideals and different formulations of the world. Sometimes this person changes for the better, and sometimes this person doesn't change for the better.
Mm-hmm.
And you can either come together, and that's, you know, again, where I'm like, bro, you need to change your shit. Like, stop doing this. Like, I don't think you understand what's going on in the world. And, you know, you give your insight. Like, I'm not just gonna, you know,
you're
not.
But is that even your friend though? As far as like that point, like, why is that person your friend? You know what I mean? Like, that's what I'm saying.
I wouldn't consider somebody that, like, that level. Friend is kind of just like tossed around anyway.
I feel like, and honestly, since you said that, I think friends are situational. Like, well, I guess I would say friends that you have for a long time are like your best friends. Like, you know, those are the people that are close to you. You can talk about anything, go anywhere, do all that shit. Then you got some that are situational where, like, you got the people that's going to be able to go to the gym with you. And then that person that you take to the gym is not going to be the same one that's going to want to go to the club.
Mm-hmm.
So you got a different friend for the club. Mm-hmm. And you got a different friend if you want to, like, there's situations or associates for each one.
Mm-hmm.
The ones that are your friend are the ones that you can actually talk about. I feel like that you can talk about anything. You can, they're going to be able to, like, if they can go anywhere and do anything with you, like, that's a friend. And if you can't do that, that's not your friend. That's just an associate for the most part.
Mm-hmm.
That's just how I feel. Because, like, anytime, like, even with friends that, like, say shit like that, like, if I can't bring that friend around other
just,
friends,
well, just
any, like,
anywhere you go,
yeah, it's kind of like it's kind of like being in a relationship and then you feel like you're cheating, so you got to go and do something, you know, like, like, that's how,
no,
I
but I, but I mean, like, you know, so you, some people do, you know, they, you know, you try and just basically fucking bat them over the head, you know, and then enough is enough. But, you know, I do know what you're saying though, like, you know, if you can't take someone around you to wherever you go, and just instinctually, you know, they're going to be able to talk to this female in the
without,
right,
yeah, without
in the right
causing
manner,
issues
or,
and shit.
Yeah, then yeah, that's just a headache waiting to happen. And I agree.
I feel like,
is there more you want to say regarding that topic, Ron? I feel like there is.
No, no. Shit. Lost my train of thought. Cause I was about to say,
I shouldn't have said nothing, huh?
Yeah. Would you just
fuck, man?
Would you just say?
Basically, just like if you can't take someone around different groups of people and, you know, and like have to babysit them and, you know, be like, oh, don't say this or don't say that. Like, that's not someone you want to move forward with.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I think I was gonna say what I was gonna say then is it's like, is that?
I'm really hungry, by the way.
Is that holding on at that point?
What do you mean?
You know what I mean? But I mean, like, okay, like,
random. Can we get G on this podcast?
Yeah. We
Jesus.
I texted her, too. She said she was busy. Maybe he's got his wedding stuff next week. Not his.
Can we get some of the wedding cast on this podcast?
Yeah, oh, yeah, definitely.
Yo, can we get the fucking, this motherfucker who is,
the what?
Who we met, or the brother?
Oh yeah,
he still hasn't been over. No, this is just a scenario.
Say his name, dude.
Nah. Say T. Come on, T.
Oh, come on, TT.
Okay, all right. So this is just a scenario
locked in.
Like, I know what you're saying. I know what you're saying. Like, just drop them. Like, they're not, you don't associate with them anymore. So, all right, let's say, again, like, I'm not, you know, this is not of relevance to any of us. Let's say your grandfather or something, or your,
I cut him off.
You wouldn't even try and say, hey, you know, maybe just
for give what? You already know how I feel about family, like.
Yeah, I mean, I don't. Like, yeah, I don't really. There's family that,
like,
I don't talk
like,
to.
That's so. Why I say, like, the biggest thing for me is my happiness. If you're not adding to that happiness, fuck you. But it's like, if you're gonna continue to like drag that person along, and
couldn't say
like,
it better.
Wrong. All you're basically doing is like stunting your happiness because you're trying to make this other person happy. Like, for what? Like, they're not trying to make you happy by being the type of friend or whatever to you, or try to come.
No,
have someone.
I just wasn't sure. Like if it's just like, no, this is just all. Like,
no, it's not like quick. It's over time. Like, for me, I give people enough rope to hang themselves.
So yeah, all right, that's what I'm saying. Like, I mean, again, it's like, you know, again, kind of back. Like, again, I don't want to just go back to what we were talking about. But like, if you know someone and you are trying to like remain, you know, in check with them. An insight.
Well, you can only try so much, man.
That's what I'm saying. But like, I wasn't sure if you're like, nah, just fucking cut them off. You know?
No. It's not quick. I mean, this person that's like
you've been cool and insight.
Stuff
like
that.
Like, you know.
But it's like some people know that, for an example, that they can still be lingering in a sense. It's like he can sit right here and have all these like ideologies, and then is basically stringing you along to be your friend, basically to like, have you. I don't know your relationship, but to have you shoot videos or you got the keys to the gym or what the fuck ever. You see what I'm saying? Mm. So it's one of those things where it's like he's conforming to you being there for whatever time period that you are, and then he's just going to fall back into his ways. Yep. Mm. And then it also...
Kind of like what we were saying, but then, I think when Ron took a little break, the lead a horse to water but can't make him drink thing, you know? Kind of like that. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But then that's where it comes down to. It's like if you've already given this person ample opportunities and then you're continuously going down that path, some along that lines, you believe the same shit that they do. That's your friend for a reason. Like, you
some
have
don't,
the same, like,
you know?
You know what I mean? Like,
I was told 1 + 1 = 2, you know? But
it's 3, but, you know.
Yeah. Some people.
Who counting?
Yeah. Some people just.
So this is, that's not nothing to like attack you or anything like that. But it's just different things, like, even for myself. I, like, when I go hang out with Tony and him and stuff like that, like, I have the hard conversations. We have those conversations, you know what I mean? It's because, like, and it, a lot of times it'd be, like, for Nashville, there was 2 black people and 1 Mexican. And we all still would have conversations like we are right now. Mm-hmm. And, like, that didn't change. Like, everybody gave their opinions, such and such, such and such. But, like, one thing for me is that, like, I like to get opinions. You know what I mean? Because I'm not perfect. Like, my thing is to basically yearn for knowledge. You know what I mean? Like, your situation is different from that person's or that person's or that person's. And so I would like to just get some sort of insight. You know what I mean? Even if it is race or, like we were talking earlier, if it's about money or cars or what have you. Mm-hmm. Like, shit, somebody probably look at it differently than I do. And so, like, I'm going to get that knowledge. And then if it's one thing where it's like, if it's something that is not the person that I am, then I will slowly, like, move away from that person. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't really have to deal
like
with
of your ideology or your
yeah, like, you know,
moral.
You know, and I feel like growing up, like, people, or even now, people try to keep people around. And it's like, keeping them around for what? You know what I mean? Because people will ask me even about Paige. It's like, oh, well, you're keeping her around. Like, is it just because it's comfortable? Like, no, it's not that. Like, I know what I have to work on. I know what's between us. You know what I mean? But everybody else, like, if you're not a part of that, like, that's why you hardly see people. Like, for what? Like, you may come over once in a while. Like, that's it.
Yeah, you might only come over once in a while or something. Like
at that. At the end of the day, man. You know, at the end of the day, man, we talked a lot about her. Talk about a lot on this podcast, man. You know,
no, definitely.
Nothing matters at the end of the day, but.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's good. Mic drop.
I'll give you a little pound.
You guys got any last words?
No last words.
This was a good one, man. We fucking killed it, bro. 3 hours.
Lots of knowledge. Happiness is key. And do not let anyone steal it. I don't give a fuck if it's your family, your girlfriend, boyfriend, or even if it's your friends. Because your happiness is what's going to keep you going for the rest of your life.
Yeah. I'm not going to try to outshine them.
I can't go here for you. That's it.
We out.
All right.
And we out.